2 weeks later.
Long time no see.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel for a very quick and completely unplanned video. I'm actually parked outside my school building. My principal asked me to come in and get some music books for a project that we're gonna do for the students should we be out of school for the rest of the year, which at this point in time, it is Friday, April 17th, and we do not know. All I do know is that today is the 4 week mark that we've been in quarantine away from school. Like, if you remember this video, this was 4 weeks ago. I cannot believe that it's 4 weeks ago, but I thought since I was here, I would give you guys an abandoned classroom tour. So stay tuned and I'll show you what my classroom looks like right now. So I just came in the front doors and it just looks so abandoned. Are off, everything's off. Amazing. I used to watch, I still watch those like abandoned hotel and abandoned places shows, like malls, hotels, whatever, and it looks kind of like that. Oh, the computer lab. This is where our classroom mailboxes are, like our teachers' mailboxes. Oh my gosh. I actually walked past my room, so I just opened my door, classroom, let's get the lights on. Here is where I turn the lights on to make it look a little less creepy. You see that I have a Welcome to Music poster. I love having these posters that just greet the students. As you walk in, you do see my filing cabinet, my trash, recycling, and my Welcome to Music sign. Over there, you also do see my clock and my megaphone. That megaphone gets used whenever I have band because I can't yell over brass instruments. And here is where I have my choir rehearse and my general music classes. You see, I have these three little areas where they can sit and there's carpet for the kindergartners. I have my piano and my smart board. My smart board, I actually love using Canva. If you want more information on that, let me know. Canva lets me design a really quick template that shows them what we're doing. Here's my personal podium and my currently charging iPad. And then this is just an extra counter I've made. I had notes and things written here on the board. Fun fact about this tour is this was what my classroom was left at. On a Thursday afternoon, we were told that Friday was the kids' last day. Get them their instruments, their folders, because we didn't know when we were returning. So this is my very unorganized counter space. These bins you see are where I keep my folders for middle school choir. I have a 5th and 6th grade folder bin and a 7th and 8th grade folder bin. And in this shot, you see the blue lid container of rhythm sticks, and behind them are my 2 crates of clipboards. That is so my kids can do their written work and their exit tickets. And there's another bin of choir music and my cups of crayons. This station here is my turn-in station. The one on the right is where kids turn in their band folders, and the ones that are in shelves are for each grade. Here's a final shot of the band and choir section. And then moving over to the other side of the classroom is the band section. Yes, this girl does band, choir, and general music. Now, this may look like a big open space, but when I do have a band class, these stools you see under the counters, I put them into rows so that the kids know where to go and where to sit. Here you can see my tree, and I store my tribal drums up top, and there's really nowhere else to put my stands. So the band stands just kind of sit there in the corner. Not the most organized thing, but working with what I have. You can also see my Mr. and Mrs. balloons because this was the year that I got married. Over here is where I do my lesson planning. I like to use the counter space because it's away from the computer, so I'm not distracted. You can see my Keurig, my canvases, my Phantom of the Opera poster. I like to have little sayings on my letterboard and then a cup of pens, pencils, and scissors. Here is my computer space with a refrigerator on the desk. This is where I will answer emails and do planning on my Google Calendar, but I like to have it as a separate place from my lesson planning. Here is a very unorganized bookshelf. If you look at the bottom, you can see my snacks and my bell choir tables, books, LaCroix, snacks up top, and my Clif Bars. I have my just games and my boom whackers, my xylophones, my bongo drums. Everything's just kind of there. It doesn't look organized once again, but as long as I know where things are and I can grab them when I need, we're all good to go. Here, what you're seeing is my bin of band essential elements books. 5 through 8 band, they can use these books. I have level 1 and 2, and then when they're ready, I get them music outside of the book so they can do actual pieces together. Another shot of the boom whackers. I don't really do boom whackers that often because I'm afraid my kids will hit each other with those. And there are my balls, my dry erase, my triangles, percussion. I have carpet squares in the back that I don't use that often because I have the big carpet. And xylophone, sadly, is what we were going to start using. That dress is from last year's production of Beauty and the Beast. The woman who donated it has not yet come to get it. And these are my musical family posters. Here's another shot of the classroom in full. There's the choir general music side, and then in the back is the band side. I do know that I'm very lucky to have this big classroom to do all of these different classes with them, but here's one last shot. And if you are also a teacher and you have a classroom tour, put it down below in the comment section.
And that is it, you guys. That is my abandoned classroom tour. If you liked it, let me know by giving this video a huge thumbs up. If you're a teacher, let me know how you're doing, what's going on, what's the status of your school. Are you returning? Are you not returning? Is the weather as lovely where you are as it is here in Ohio, where last week it was 65 and 70 degrees and now it's 42 and rainy slash snowing sometimes? Hang in there, guys. Be positive. Let me know if there are any videos you want to see, and let me know how you still like the onesie one take series and Financial Friday. Thinking about taking a break from Financial Friday and maybe focusing on vlogs for a while just to see like what's happening in life, but we'll see. At least the Wednesday videos will stay constant because I want to do that series for a year. But anyway, enough jabbering from me. Take care. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.